We are pearls.
Captain's log. Thursday. Stardate. Space is really messed up. Everything is big. Our Nova thrusters are busted. Getting home is taking forever.
Hey, Captain, should we be writing this down?
Who wants a party sub?
What exactly are we celebrating?
You guys beat me and Connie, and you rescued the Jungle Moon. And you have this Super Pickles ship, so you'll be back on Earth in no time.
It's only super when it works.
Captain Rose, I've finished.
Power from the gravity engine to the Nova thruster? Great! Twins, floor it on the thrusters!
Yes, Captain. Right away, Captain.
Captain Lars, don't use the thrusters. We're going to lose power!
Hey, there's somebody I'd like you all to meet.
Are they bigger?
They have to be.
Fine.
He's going to bring back another Steven!
Another Steven?
Twins!
There's more of you?
Fusion?
This is Garnet. She leads the crystal gems back.
I predict you're going to make everyone uncomfortable.
Just look at you all. You must be a ruby and a pearl. That must have been a story. I want all the details. And you must be... I've never seen anyone like you before.
We were...
Fluorite. Whoa. You're just...
Wrong!
And here's Pat Peretta. And Sapphire. How rare.
It's nice to make fun of us like that.
Haven't you guys heard a sandwich before?
Sandwich?
You know, it's when someone says something nice about you.
Who would say nice things about us? We should all be ashamed.
Oh, Steven. These gems feel just like I did before I met...
Rose!
What?
You met Pearl!
And you survived?
Don't be silly.
Pearl
isn't real.
You have it all wrong! Of course that's how they tell it on Homeworld. Come on, everyone. Let me tell you the story of the real Quartz. It was Era 1. The planet Earth.
Every gem was made to serve Pink Diamond, each with a role to play in Homeworld's perfect empire. In comparison to their creator, their existence was ordinary. They were life forms only meant to fit their mold. And no one had ever dared to think otherwise.
Until there was
Peridot.
In stature, she was no different. However, she began to take notice of her strange colony and the life that existed there. Appreciation turned to love. Soon, she was unable to keep Pink Diamond. Rose Quartz was summoned at once.
Quartz, began Pink Diamond. What have you been saying down there?
Bear's life. Pink Diamond thought for a moment and then laughed. A wicked, empty sound.
Don't be absurd.
She had to fight.
I predict this story won't have a happy ending.
Is this what you want, or will you join it? Rose's message began to resonate to Pink Diamond's dismay. She called for her diamond allies, yellow and blue, to help. Rose Quartz threw her rebel blade. It shattered Pink Diamond. The other diamonds were furious. In a last-ditch attempt to wipe out the rebellion, the diamonds launched a direct... used their powers to end the fighting, once and for all.
We were all told the same stories. But they all ended different.
This new version of the story is even great. So she was worse. And they beat her? What are we supposed to get out of this? That we can never win?
We haven't yet, but we can. We are running from the truth. And the truth is, we are Pink Diamond.
But how many more?
More than you think. I was only on homeworld for like...
Look at you. You can show everyone.
I predict you're going to make everyone uncomfortable.
We can do...
Not while we're floating out here like sitting ducks. Fluorine, let's take another look at that engine.
How do we do that?
I predict that Captain Lars will be pressing the wrong button.
Hey, Amethyst. When I was stranded on the jungle moon, I saw a vision of Connie. What if that means she's still out there?
And she's gone. You have empathetic powers that other gen have. You're unusual, Steven.
Oh. Yes! We did it!
Does that mean you can-
Not quite.
We can hit up the nearest colony for parts. A Rhodonite, tell me there's one nearby.
Well, we aren't far from one of Yellow Diamond's asteroid mines, but that-
Let's show 'em!